Hey y'all, what's going on? Sorry, I'm like a couple seconds late. I had came to Virginia last night and I'm on my way back, so I needed a parking lot to sit in real quick. And this dude was like looking out of a window. I mean, I don't even know why he's there this early, right? These stores are not even open. But anyway, I had to relocate because I didn't want him to call the cops on me for sitting in front of the store. So anyway, that's why I was a few seconds late. But what's going on, y'all? What's up? Welcome to this morning's episode of If You Woke Up, You're Winning. My name is Panique Singleton from connectwithpanique.com. How are y'all doing today? Hope everybody's having a great day. Today is Wednesday, right? So we're halfway through the week for those of you guys who have a work week that goes Monday through Friday. So look, let me get to the point. This week, you know, earlier this week, we've been talking about the law of diminishing intent, right? Which, just as a refresher, that law says that the longer you wait to do something that you should do now, the greater the odds that you will never actually do it, right? So we've been talking about that all week. And then I share with you some tips to avoid falling into that trap, right? To avoid this happening to you. So today, matter of fact, I encourage you guys to go back and check out those videos from Monday and Tuesday if you missed them, right? So today, I actually want to talk to you about one of the biggest reasons that the law of diminishing intent is even a thing, right? Like one of the biggest reasons that even happens. And one of the biggest reasons is fear, okay? Fear is like one of the biggest reasons that people put things off, you know, that people procrastinate, that people delay doing something. A lot of times it's because they are scared, right? And there's all different types of fear. There's all these different fear factors that come into place, right? So today I want to talk to you a little bit about the biggest fear factor, okay? Because in order to fix something, in order to correct something, you have to know what the issue is, right? So the biggest fear factors, one of the biggest fear factors is failure, okay? Fear of failure, okay? So many people are scared to fail at something, right? How many of you guys have ever failed at something? You know, hit the like button if you failed, because sometimes by the time y'all type comments, it comes through like 5 minutes later. But hit the like button if you ever failed at something, or if I could see you guys, raise your hand if you ever failed. I know I can't see you, but if I said raise your hand if you ever failed at something, I bet every single one of you would raise your hand, right? And so my next question is, raise your hand if you died. Did anybody die? Did anybody die? If you failed, did you die? Probably not. Okay, I can't see y'all, but I'm assuming nobody is raising their hand, right? So it's not going to kill you. So why are we so scared of it? Fear of failure is actually such a big deal that it has a name. Did y'all know it had a name? I Googled this, right? Google is my friend, okay? The name is called atychophobia. Have y'all ever heard of that? Atychophobia means fear of failure, right? So anyway, my thing is today I just want to talk to you about it a little bit. So why are we scared to fail? It's because we're conditioned and we're taught at a very young age that failure is bad, right? We go to school, we take a test or something, we get grades, and we're taught we need to get an A. If you get an F, you fail. And if you get an F, that's bad, right? You feel horrible about yourself because that's what we're taught. But in real life, right, in the real world, failing is actually good, right? There's a quote by Woody Allen that says, if you're not failing every now and again, it's a sign that you're not doing anything very innovative, right? Isn't that good, guys? If you're not failing, you're not trying anything new. You're not stepping outside of your comfort zone, right? Because like I said, failing is good because it allows you the chance to learn and grow, right? When you fail, you can learn what doesn't work so that you can change and you can tweak and figure out what does work. So it's good to fail, right? You've heard the term trial and error, right? You try something, you make an error, you try something else, right? And then eventually you're going to figure it out, okay? You're going to figure it out. Now, I don't know if you've ever heard the phrase from my network marketers and my entrepreneurs. I'm sure you guys have heard this phrase, fail fast and fail often, right? Because the faster you fail, the faster you can figure out what actually works, right? So if I go ahead and get the failures out of the way, I'm going to get to the success. So fail fast and fail often, all right? I mean, I like the saying, sometimes you win and sometimes you learn, you know, because you never lose. If you learn a lesson, you never lose, right? And that's what my manager at work always tells us. You know, you guys know I underwrite loans and we get a rating on every loan. And if we get a bad rating, if we don't get an acceptable rating, you know, a lot of times we're upset or whatever. And then she's like, but did you learn something? And she get on my nerves with that, but she's right. Because the the point, I'm sorry, I don't know why I got tongue-tied right there, but the point is learning a lesson, right? It doesn't always, everything doesn't always have to be perfect. You don't always have to get an A, right? It's okay to get an F as long as you learn something, right? So I had to realize that she was right, right? Don't you hate that moment when you like, dang, she actually does know something, you know? Does that ever happen to y'all? Sometimes I hate admitting that people are right. I'm just joking, guys. So look, I could go on all day about this topic, but I'm not going to, because you know we try to keep it short in the mornings. But I do want to leave you with this. You know, many people that are very, very successful now have failed at some point in their life, right? I mean, think about Oprah, you know, Michael Jordan, Walt Disney, Steven Jobs, Steven Spielberg, Stephen King. Matter of fact, if your name is Steven, you have a higher chance of failing, I think. I'm just kidding. I'm just joking. That was just coincidence that all those guys' names were Steven. But if your name is Steven and you're watching, I love you. You're going to be great, right? You're already great. But anyway, guys, so let me get back on track. But seriously, my point is, it is okay to fail because it builds character, it makes you stronger, and it helps you learn what you need to be doing, guys. So do not be scared of failure. Go out there and fail today. Matter of fact, not only am I going to tell you to get off of Facebook, okay, and go out there and be great on purpose, I'm also going to tell you today, go out and fail at something right now, right? Go get out of here and go fail at something, but share this video first, right? Like, comment, and share if you found value in this video. If I said something you liked, if I said something that resonated with you, go ahead and share this on your page so other people can benefit from this information, all right? So I appreciate all you guys watching live. Good morning, Chan, Keela, Leroy, India, anybody else who is watching live and anybody who's watching the replay. I appreciate y'all hanging out with me in the morning, as I enjoy talking to y'all in the morning. So now I'm going to get off of this Facebook and get on this road back to North Carolina, all right? So y'all have an awesome and amazing day. Again, my name is Panique Singleton from connectwithpanique.com. I'm here every weekday morning at 6:45 a.m. So I will see y'all tomorrow morning. Y'all have a great Wednesday. Talk to y'all later.